gives loopholes and things to benefit others. But when God gives us instructions, He edits all the instructions. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We have also more sure word of prophecy. Whereunto you do well, that He said, heed. You are doing well because you are eating well. You are doing well because you take heed. It is useless to listen to the word of God and you don't make it something important to you. It is useless. Many people don't value the word of God. Many people don't respect the word of God. Many people are not afraid of the word of God. And therefore they handle the word of God anyhow. I am afraid. Your respect and my respect of God put some kind of fear in us, that we can't handle the word of God in the heart. Hallelujah. Peter said, you do well by paying attention unto the word of God as unto a light that shines in dark places until the day is dawn and the day star arises in your hearts. Until the truth is known. Until you come into the daylight and Jesus Christ is revealed in your heart. Jesus is the morning star. When He is revealed in your heart, Samuel, go and sit back there. When He is revealed in your heart, then the day has broken. Isaiah said, whom has the Lord been revealed? Whom has the hand of the Lord been revealed? That was exactly what Brother Peter was saying. The hand of the Lord will be revealed unto us. Only when we feed properly on the word of God. Only when we feed properly on the word of God. When we eat the word of God anyhow, and we use the word of God anyhow, beloved, let us be very, very careful. I think I had teachings on time past. They all had this opportunity. People who are in hell, they have this opportunity that we are having, but they abuse it. People who are in the lake of fire now, they have these chances that you and me are having, but they abuse it.
Oh, yeah.
They all once have this opportunity, which they didn't make good use of it. Do you know how many people who are sitting today, lying now, doing nothing, today is Sunday? So if the Lord to come and say that only this church to go to heaven, will you believe us? It will be something that will shock you. And I know I'm going. I don't know about you.
Yeah, we're all going.
So when I said, like the Lord said, only this church is going, it seems you don't believe in me.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Beloved, let us be very serious. Unless you have made up your mind that you want to make heaven, you will live your life anyhow. This message that we are preaching, it won't benefit you. It won't benefit you. Let us make good use of. If we want to make heaven, if we want to be committed, we need a nutritious food. And that nutrition is the word of God, spoken undiluted, spoken unpolluted, spoken in lovely manner that will let you reach out for it. The Bible that people are holding, there are some parts plugging out of it. Sister Farida had a dream. And in her dream, somebody was giving her Bible. That part has been removed out of it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So she asked me, Pastor, what does it mean? I said, well, I pray that it's not me. But it means that some that person is sharing something of God with you, but it's not complete. Somebody who is standing as, because a person who carry Bible is a Christian. He is a pathway set. And the way that a person is living his life or her life, so that particular person that Lord is telling you, the Bible that she or he is living his life on, part is torn. It's not living on complete Bible. Whom do you allow to teach you? I challenge you to pray over your doctrine. I challenge you to pray over the doctrines that you live your life on. It might not be balanced diet. When you go to second rescue, where we were being sustained, even it was sustained us. Every person I went to boarding school will tell you it is not a good place to be because you can't eat what you want. We are going to eat, we are going to eat. When you go, one spoon, ladle, one ladle of soup or garri or beans or cocoa, curry. Without milk. Without milk. And it has become so fermented and so demonic that when you eat it after breakfast, those tutors or masters or teachers, right after breakfast, they must be very careful because the student will be sleeping. And you have to eat it, but that is the only food you eat. There were some students that they wouldn't eat. Yet it was compulsory. You must be at the dining hall. Even those who we are being forced to eat. Toxic. You become drunk. Because it is demonic food. The one that is preparing that food never prayed on it. You don't know what she or he possesses. The pantry boys who are serving it. Do you know who they are? The matron who gave those menu to be prepared. Do you know who they are? Do you know the source of those food? And that is why the word of God is the only food for your spirit.
Amen.
Be very careful who is feeding you with the word of God. Be very careful. Because now everybody is serving. Everybody is doing it. Everybody. Since everybody's doing it, a gentleman just came to me this week, and the way he expressed himself, I believe that the Lord sent him. So he said, I wish I would know much or learn more. I said, yes, I'll be very happy. And he gave me his pastor that he's following. Immediately I saw the pastor, the Lord said, this is TB Joshua's son. So I wrote a boy, I said, well, I don't know your pastor, but I see a spirit on him. Can you tell me, he said, pastor, gospel to you. He is the son of this man. I said, wow. All right. Your assignment, I don't want to say anything to you. Your assignment is leave that place for 3 days. Go and fast and ask God. Who is this man? Is he your son? Because the boy seems to be very, very willing and hungry for food, bread food. People are eating everything without discerning. That was what we learned last Friday. People are eating everything to know without sitting down to know the ingredients. Like I said, a little Samuel. Because of Samuel, when his mother came into your house, she will ask you, what did you put in this food? What did you put in this food? In other words, when someone eats it, is it going to help you? Mama will always ask before she will give the food to the boy. If she doesn't, she will sleep, and that will be upset, by the way. There we go. So somebody said, Daddy will react. It is very painful. Why? Because the moment the boy will eat, he'll be coming, scratching his body, sleepless, agitation. The reaction will come quickly. It's just by the grace of God that prayers has reduced and taken all this thing off. Yet, she still has to be very cautious. Ask what they put in before you eat it. Before you eat it, ask what they put in. You can't eat anything. And that is why the Lord is saying that before you go and buy the ingredients to come and prepare the food, ask him first. What are you eating? Do you know the ingredients that make up? Rome was not built at a day. So whenever you see a building standing within a short period of time, something is wrong. Either that building was not properly built, or it's a fake. Back home in Africa, you and me will approve that before a person will build a story building, it will cost him a lot. Cost time and cost money. Cost energy, cost everything. You want a story building in heaven, and you're living your life anyhow. You want good reward in heaven, and you don't want to be active in these graves. You don't want to use these graves to help others. You don't want to use this grace to let people benefit from you. You don't want to use this grace. You're always receiving and receiving and receiving. Let people come and bless me. How many times do you want to bless others? How many times? We will have no reward. We will have no reward if we don't take care. There are many Christians that are going to have reward in heaven, by the way. Heaven, they will go. You are saying, no, Pastor, but if I make heaven, that's enough.
Yes.
You shouldn't have that kind of mindset. You should desire more. Say, I desire more.
I desire more.
I desire more.
I desire more.
If I am going to heaven, then I need to enjoy it to the full. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't be kind of mediocrity, Christian. That everything goes. Don't be like that. Don't be like that. Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12 say the word of God is active. It is active. It will make those who eat active. It makes those who eat spiritually active. So when you eat and you are spiritually weak, meaning that you are not feeding on the proper food. Hebrews chapter 4. Please read the verse 12 with me. For the word of God is living and active. Sharper than any double-edged sword.
It penetrates.
It pierces. It penetrates. Even the dividing soul. It ascends. It separates. It breaks. Only the word of God can differentiate the soul and the spirit. It penetrates through our joints and our marrows. It judges our thoughts and our attitude of the hearts. It judges. It brings discernment. It brings discernment of the thoughts and the intents of the hearts. You see, last week we were trying, Friday, we were trying to understand what discernment means. Judgment. Having the right judgment. Having the right judgment. Discernment is having the right judgment. Everything that you are feeling is the same as God is saying. Like I said, this young boy came, this young brother. I don't like using voice. Unless I know it's a child. That is how pastors, modern pastors, they call Christian brothers and sisters. This is a young boy. Me, I'm a small boy for some of these bishops. What does he know? Whose school did he go? What does he know? Right. Those who are feeding on good food, they don't look down upon others. But they regard every person because the same food that you are eating is the same people are eating. You know, when we eat good food than other people, we are proud of them. People who are eating some kind of food which is not rich man's food, we look down upon them.
Which food is
a rich man's food, Mama? When you go to Africa, those who are eating fresh food, they are the rich people, isn't it? If you are eating stockfish and fried fish, it's a sour and other things. You don't consider yourself as a rich man, but that basically is supposed to be a rich man's food.
Yes.
That's nutritious, very, very nutritious food. What are you eating matters in the house of God. What you are eating matters, brothers and sisters. Who is your pastor? Who is your pastor? Do you know the spirit behind that pastor? Receive, and you are receiving. I claim it in Jesus' name. I receive. They throw it on you. Receive. Receive, and you are receiving. I receive. I receive. Do you know what you are eating? Do you understand that receive? Do you know what you are receiving? If you want to eat well, know what is. What are the ingredients of those food? My children want to learn how to cook, how to bake most of the time. So every now and then when I come on my computer, I see they are studying some how the ingredients. Today is very common for children to learn certain things. So they can't be bothered all the time to stay at the kitchen because they know that when they go to the Google, they can find all the ingredients. Anytime they come to me and daddy, do we have this? That means they want to cook. Sometimes it doesn't go the way it is at the end of the day. Because what is written there will give you the ingredients. But how it may come at the end depends upon how you do it. Some people are like that. They read the Bible and tell others. So at the end of the day, it doesn't. My first time I was making cake. A young lady showed me how to make cake. You can take it. And you know, some of us, we don't take measurements.
No.
So I put it. When I finished, it was like a tight. You know the tight. It wasn't cake.
Still one.
I didn't tell her I'm not going to give until my wife came and she started preparing me a proper cake. However, I was preparing cake. To me, it was a cake. Understand what you are eating. The ingredients you may have served, however, it might not bring you. The outcome might not be the same. Yes, the measurement counts. The word of God. The word of God can change every person. The word of God can make every person fulfill this grace. Only the word of God. So let us depend upon the word of God. If we want to make it, why? Because the word of God is the only way that we can be saved. Let's read short, quickly. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 15. 2 Peter 3, 15. If we want to be saved, we need the word of God. There is no word given to us that a man can be saved except the word of God.
2 Peter chapter 3.
Verse 15, please.
Bear in mind that
our Lord's presence means salvation.
Just as our dear brother Paul also wrote to you.
Just as brother Paul made it aware unto you.
With the wisdom that God gave him.
With the wisdom that Apostle Paul had, that the word of God is our salvation. Jesus is the word of God. So if you want to have salvation, we need Jesus. If you want to have salvation, we need the word of God. Now we need a proper thought word of God. Not man-made word of God about today. Not man-made. We are presenting the word of God for their benefits, for their fame. I'll say it over and over again. If you have a pastor who has bodyguards around him, That pastor does not depend upon God. He depends upon the arms of flesh. The word of God gives us salvation. Jeremiah chapter 15, verse 16. Let's remain in 1 Peter. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 2. The word of God gives us spiritual food. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 2. 1 Peter 2, 2.
1 Peter 2, verse 2.
Love, can you open Jeremiah 15, 16 for me? 1 Peter 2, 2. You can't find 1 Peter.
Like a newborn baby.
Desire for it.
So that by it you may grow up.
By it you may grow up.
In your salvation.
In your salvation.
Amen.
To grow up in spiritual things depend upon the word of God that you are hearing. Unless you understand the word of God, it will never manifest the nature of Christ in us. Like I tell you, my baking experience. Sometimes it was bent. And I think the church was doing something, I was just making too low. I know how to make. And before I was aware, the cake was bent. You leave it in the fire because you don't follow anything, provided you think that you are doing it. Sometimes that it was less, and in me, I add everything. I can add milk, I can add water, I can add oil. If I don't have margarine, I add oil. If how I cook my food is how I live my Christian life, I would never make heaven. I eat everything. I enter into the fridge, I can cook, so I do it. I put it, take everything in there, and I add it up. And when you come up, it tastes very good. And sometimes it will give you stomachache. Last night I don't know what I ate, but this morning I was feeling so bad, so I had to run quickly into province. Desire, true word of God. If you want to make heaven, desire. What he is preaching and get affirmation from God. How can I know that the person I'm following is true man of God? His teachings and his instructions changes everything in my life. Hallelujah. There have been some people that the Lord has brought to me. Can you see through? Sure. There have been some brothers and sisters that the Lord has brought on our ways. They testify that indeed there is a change in their life. This morning, one of our sisters just was talking to me and she said, people are witnessing Christ in me. People are witnessing a change in me. And I know that Brother Gabriel, I thank God that God brought me to study the word of God that you are preaching.
Amen.
If the master that we are hearing is not changing us, if the master that we are hearing is not adding values, if the master that we are hearing is not bringing the nature of Christ in us, it is not a good message. The nature of Christ in us is not miracle. When I lay my hands upon people, they are saved. Yet you are fornicator. When I lift up my voice, I prophesy. Yet you are a masturbator. You are pornography. You are somebody that spends all your time on football. Watch unnecessary things. That takes your peace and the peace of God away from you. It doesn't matter what you are doing. If Christ is not being fully formed in you,
amen,
meaning that you are not eating the good food, he said, as a newborn baby, desire. Desire the word of God, which is the spiritual food that will nourish your spiritual life. Jeremiah 16. Mama, open Acts chapter 20, 32 for me. Jeremiah 16. 15, 16.
Okay. I read in
Jesus'
name.
Amen.
Your words were found.
Your words were found.
And I ate them.
And I ate them.
And your word was to me.
Your word was to me.
The joy and rejoicing of
my heart. The joy and the rejoicing of my heart. Whenever we listen to the word of God, we must have a joy and a strength that motivates us to live as the word is saying.
O Lord God of hosts, I did not sit in the assembly of the
mall.
Nor did I rejoice. I sat alone because...
Please, can you sit down? Stop movements when I'm preaching. Because the word of God is coming. Angels are here. And they are taking notice of everything. So behave in the presence of God, please. Is that a 16 or you jump over?
I'm on 17 now.
Please remain on 15 and 16 for me.
Okay, that's
Hallelujah. The word of God is our spiritual food and grant us spiritual strength and spiritual growth. Acts 20:32. Spiritual growth. The word of God is our spiritual growth. Acts chapter 20:32.
Acts chapter 20. Verse 32. Now I commit you to God and to the word of grace.
I commit you to God and to the word of his grace.
Which can build you up.
Which can build you up.
And give you an inheritance.
And gives you an inheritance.
Among all those who are sanctified.
Among those. So did you hear that? The word of God will give us growth. And that growth will produce inheritance in heaven for us. Yolita, what is your battery? Is it okay? Psalm 119. Go to Psalm 119 for me. The word of God grants us salvation. Number two, the word of God is our spiritual food. Number three, the word of God promotes growth and inheritance.
Psalm
119, we're going to read the verse number 99 and 100. Verse 99 and 100, the word of God grant us wisdom.
Psalm 119, verse 99 to
100.
I have more insight than
I have more wisdom, insight, understanding than my predecessors.
My teachers.
For I meditated upon your statutes.
I have more understanding
than the elders.
So I obey.
That because I obey your commandments. When we obey the word of God, we get understanding and we get what? Wisdom.
Amen.
The word of God is the source of wisdom. That is why a child of God needs to depend upon the word of God. That where will I keep in my heart? That I may not sway, that I may not turn away from you. The word of God, the same one that let's read 9 and 11, it cleanses us. The word of God is a cleansing agent. It cleanses us from every toxin, every filthy thing. It cleanses us. Ephesians 5, the word of God cleanses us. Read it. Psalm 119, 9 to 11, please.
Psalm 119, verse 9 to 11, I read it.
How can a young man keep his way pure?
By living according
to your commandments.
I seek with all my heart. Do not let me sway.
From your heart.
I have hidden your word in my heart.
I have hidden your word in my heart.
That I may not sin.
That where will I hidden in my heart? That where will I live in my heart? That I may not sin. is having the word of God in your heart.
Amen.
You didn't say amen.
Amen.
You don't want to know clue how to avoid sin? Mm-hmm. The only clue how to avoid sin is to have the word of God ruling your heart, ruling your mind, ruling your understanding. The word of God. Eat it well. Don't eat it anyhow. Because it is a cleansing agent. John 15 verse 3. Jesus said, you are clean because of the word that I have spoken to you. You are clean as you are hearing the word of God. Angels are washing you. People who hear from us, the angels of the Lord come down and wash them. They untie them. They remove the crutches from their legs and their hands. Hallelujah. Absence of the word of God, humanity was in slavery and in bondage. And when the word of God, which is tried in fire, when it comes into our life, it sets us free.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
David said, clean me and I will be clean. Wash me and I will be washed. Purge me. Purge me by your words. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The word of God cleanses us. John, let's remain there. Let's remain there. That's 105 in Psalm 119 again. I didn't tell you to open John 15, so why did you open there?
Psalm 119,
verse 105. The word of God is our guidance. The reason why we need the word of God is, number one, is our salvation. Number two is our spiritual food. Number three is our spiritual growth, basis. Number four is our wisdom. Number five is our understanding. Number six is our guidance.
Psalm 119, verse 105. I read, your word is a lamp.
Your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light for my path.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Back home in Africa, where we don't have access to light, lighting system. Even here in Europe, when I was living in Germany, when you drive on a motorway, there are lights all over. Everywhere's lights, most places. So when I came into the UK and I reached a place, there was no light. I said, whoa. In the night, I was driving, I was expecting to see lights all over. I think even in Germany, they have changed that. They might be switching off the lights on the road sometimes.
Why?
It costs them a huge amount. Keeping the lights on the road is very, very expensive. They take tax. You know why they use the tax for so many things? Your brothers and sisters who don't want to work, giving birth to 3, 4, 5 children with their husbands. Mm-hmm. And they are saying that husband, they don't know the husband.
They're
lazy and they are in Church of Pentecost and Church of Baptist, and they are praising God every day. Mm-hmm. They are going to hell. This money that they take, they give it to them. You think that they are taking tax to do any good thing? They pay for lazy people, most African people. They are cheating the system, abusing the system. Here on Sunday, they call themselves Christians in the church. What church is that? They can work, they do black job, and they take money here. The husband is working, and the wife is a housewife. Every day, that sister is giving birth, but we don't know the husband. May God have mercy upon you, sister, if you are that. Go and do that restitution ASP. Because hell is waiting on you. The word of God, verse 8:28, gives us comfort. 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 Psalm 119, verse 28. The word of God comforts our souls. When do we need comfort? When there is no peace.
Psalm 119, verse 28.
Uh-huh.
I read, my soul is weary with sorrow.
My soul is weary with sorrow.
Strengthen me according to your word.
Strengthen me according to your word. The word of God bring us joy. The word of God bring us blessings. The word of God bring us joy. Jesus told his disciples, Now that you have received my word in John chapter number 15, verse 11, you are rejoicing. John 15, verse 11, quickly, let's go there. What the word of God will do for you, we are rushing through today to understand. Take your time, go and watch the video on YouTube, go and watch it on Facebook again, sit down. Especially those of you who are always distracted by your children, take your time and listen to that because it will help you. John chapter 15, verse 11.
John chapter 15.
And Deuteronomy chapter 28, love.
Verse
Mama,
11.
Read John 15 for me, 11.
Verse 11, it says, I have taught you this so that my joy may be in you.
I have given you my word so my joy may be in you.
And that your joy may be complete.
That your joy will be completed. Don't you like listening to the word of God? I don't know the source of your joy, but my source of joy is reading the word of God. My source of joy is, to me, not hearing what other people are saying. Yes, of course, when I hear what heaven seekers, what the other pastors that I affirm them, what they are teaching, I read them, I study them, and I love it, because they give me more understanding, and the word of God finally grants us blessing. Deuteronomy chapter 28. Chapter 28, verse 1 going. The Lord commanded the children of Israel that if you want to be blessed, follow this thing. And he gave blessings. Verse 1, please, let's go.
Verse 1. Now it shall come to pass.
It shall come to pass.
If you diligently obey the voice.
If you diligently obey what Brother Gabriel is teaching.
To observe carefully.
To observe carefully.
All his commandments.
All the Lord has commanded her.
Which I command you today.
Which I am reading to you today.
That the Lord your God will set you high above
all the nations of the earth. Continue.
2. And all these blessings shall come upon
and
you.
And blessings will come upon you.
And overtake you.
And it shall overtake you.
Because you obey.
Because you are obedient.
The voice of your
God. The only thing in the word of God that we are hearing demand is what? Obedience. Trust in the word of God and obey it. Trust it. All that it means to obey. To obey me, put it into practice. Love it, cherish it, welcome it. Continue, darling.
Verse 3.
Uh-huh.
Blessed shall be you in the city.
Blessed will be with you when you are in the city.
And blessed shall be you in the country.
Blessed will be in the country.
4.
4.
Blessed shall be the fruit of your body.
Blessed will be the children that come out of you.
The produce of your ground.
The fruits that you bear in your field.
And the increase of your herds.
The increase of your animals. Blessing will be them.
And the increase of your cattle.
And the increase of your cattle.
And the offspring of your flock.
And the offspring of your flock. In other words, it's okay. Now go and start setting up the communion. Finish your job. Last job needs to be done. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is worthless for us to wake up early in the morning. It is useless for live here on earth, pay our tithes and offering, dresses, like Sister Linda have dressed today, very beautiful. The changing is now there. Now she is purely holiness.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
God bless you.
The change has now taken effect. Man is going to change. Gradually, it has been about 2 months now. Now she is on track physically. And spiritually, we believe that the Lord is changing things in us.
Amen.
That is what we are talking about. Let the word of God change you. How do you see yourself? Take this picture, put it on your Facebook, and people are going to admire you. Today, don't go out without taking a picture. I don't like Facebook pictures, but please take a Facebook picture today and put it on your profile. Remove all those dirty ones and start putting some pictures. And the glory of God will reflect, and your friends and your relatives will see that there is a change. There is a change. The word of God changes us to become more Christians. Mm. To become more admirable and discerning. Oh, hallelujah. Woo! If you are not engaged today, I have some brothers who I will ask them to go on your profile picture. I have Christian brother that tell me, Pastor, I need a woman, but I want holiness woman. That is why when you come, I am so serious. Hey, do whatever is necessary. We have about 4 or 5 men now. Already made. We are waiting for Christian sisters that are holding. And they all come. They say, brother, we know. Some come to my wife. I know that you will have somebody who is practicing holiness. Brothers are searching. But they can't find. They are looking for Christ in their homes. I don't see many Christians that have come. I've never had one of them that come and say, brother, please help me to find a husband. But I have the voice. They come every day. So sisters, if we do well,
tell them,
we will rejoice. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Let us put the message that we are hearing. The message that people preach did not benefit them. Because they did not add faith to it. Let us trust and obey. Shall we rise up? Shall we rise up? If you are at home, and those of you who are on Zoom, God bless you. I believe you are with us. Now take your bread. If you haven't got them, your bread and your wine, or your drink, not the wine per se, but your drink. We're going to cry unto God. We're going to cry unto God for God to prepare us as a sanctuary. We want an inheritance in heaven. We want an inheritance in heaven. We don't want to labor in vain. We don't want our life here to be throwing out our chances to make heaven. Talk to God. Prepare me, Lord, to be a sanctuary. To be a sanctuary for you. Make me pure and holy. Make me pure and holy. Try my heart so low. Sing with me, Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary. Pure and holy. Try that tree with thanksgiving.
You gave me your word.
He died on the cross.
He died on the cross.
to set my soul free.
To set my soul free.
Your word, which is the living life,
has given me a living bread
to feed on him. He has given me a living water
to drink
that I may not thirst again.
We have received
your
word,
which has drawn us closer to you,
to
desire more of you,
to
be changed into your likeness, to be made under your statutes.
This afternoon,
I have this token of bread in my hands.
I have this token of bread in my hands.
That is the bread of life.
That is the bread of life.
That your promise says,
those
who feed on you
shall never hunger.
Spiritually,
physically,
as I eat your bread of life,
feed me
with spiritual strength,
spiritual ability,
spiritual power.
I want to live for you.
In the name of Jesus,
I have this
wine
in my heart
as a token of your blood
that you shed
for me
to make
a covenant with my soul.
My soul longs for you.
My soul desires.
My soul thirsts
for you.
Therefore,
as I have this cup in my hand,
I turn it into your
blood.
The blood
that washes
away my sins.
The blood
that grants
me inheritance
in heavenly
places.
The blood
that heals
my sickness.
That heals
my infirmity.
That gives
me strength
from there.
To
walk
and not be tired,
to become more committed
into
heavenly things.
As I bring
the power,
I receive
the strength
to fight
this battle.
I receive
the strength
to
run the race
without being tired.
To them that
wait upon you,
they shall renew
their strength.
They shall
mount up
wings
like
eagles.
As I bring
the blood,
let the
eagle spirit
that
soar high.
Let the
eagle spirit
that
fight
against every other
man.
Let it come upon
me.
The strength
from above.
Those who depend
upon you.
The lion
on the tribe of Judah.
They become
lions.
Make me
a lion.
Make me a
lion.
Make
my feet
strong like a deer.
As
I drink the blood
and
I eat the flesh.
Let
every weakness in me.
Let every weakness in
me. Let it be taken away.
Let it be taken
away. As I drink
the blood.
I need a
change.
I know you can't change
me. I know you can change me.
Every spiritual food.
Every spiritual food.
That is toxic.
That is toxic.
That I have ever eaten.
As I drink the blood.
I break every covenant. I come into covenant relationship with you.
I come into covenant.
That's from this day forward.
I'll
become the light.
I'll
become the way.
I'll become the way.
To other people.
To other people.
Who want to know you more.
Who want to know you more.
As I drink the blood.
As I drink the blood.
I surrender all to you.
I surrender all to you.
And I say, Lord.
And I say, Lord.
If you can use me.
If you can use me.
Use me.
Use me.
To bring glory.
To bring glory.
And honor.
And honor.
Into your house.
Into your house.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus'
name. Now drink the blood. And eat the fresh. Eat the flesh.
Oh, the blood that gives me strength.
From there to there. Into the
to the Lord.
Wherever
From there to there, it will never lose its power. It reaches to the highest mountain, and it flows
to the lowest valley.
Oh, the blood that gives me strength. From death to death, it will never lose its power. Say, the blood of Jesus will never lose its power. The blood of Jesus will never be exhausted. The word of God will change me. Lord Jesus, your word I have received today is making a way for me. Your word I have received today is leading me onto the right path. Your word I have received today is bringing glory. It's changing me, bringing beauty, divine beauty, and granting me understanding. In the name of Jesus, your word make me wiser. Your word grant me insight. Your word guides me in all acts of righteousness. Your word is washing me, cleansing me, preparing me as a bride adorned for the bridegroom. Oh Jesus, if you can do anything beyond what I think, beyond what I desire, with your word, let it be that I will become more like you. Purify my heart, let it be as gold and precious silver. Purify my heart, let me be as gold, pure gold, refine as my heart's one desire is to be holy. That's my desire. Set me apart for you. Set me apart for you, Lord. I'm ready to do your will. Oh, refine me, Lord. Refine me, Lord. My heart is that your desire, brother, my sister, who is watching me? Is that your desire to be holy for the Lord? What is hidden? What is taking you from being holy for the Lord? We don't want to close our teachings without giving an opportunity to identify yourself or me for Jesus Christ. To ask Him to change you for the better. Pray this prayer. Set me apart. If you are listening to us and you've not given your life to Jesus yet and you have not become committed, pray this short prayer after us. Say, Jesus.
Jesus.
I believe that you're the Son of God. I believe that you died on the cross For a sinner such I. Lord, forgive me of all my sin. Cleanse me from all unrighteous acts. Give me your heart, please. Give me your spirit, Lord. And set me apart on fire. Grant me your blazing fire. And let me live my life for you. In Jesus' name. If you have prayed that prayer, we want you to understand the Lord God that we serve and that who is coming for us have listened to that prayer. We challenge you to look for a Bible-based church. If you don't have any church, why don't you continue to follow us on Facebook, on YouTube 24/7. Join us. My name is Pastor Gabriel Adade or Love Adade. On these Facebook names, you will always have videos and messages that will prepare you for heaven. Without much ado, with our brothers and sisters in France, in Italy, in Germany, in Spain, and in Sweden, and where is Sister Matilda? Finland. God bless you, and sisters in London who join us today. God richly bless you. We love you, and we know that the Lord is preparing us for His better place. You hear that they are saying that heaven seekers, they have their city. I believe the Lord is preparing a city for us also.
Amen.
Which we're going to be under heaven seekers.
Amen.
City as well.
Amen.
So shall we all in one accord share the grace of God together?
May the grace
of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore.
Amen.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
God richly bless you all.
God bless you all.
God bless you for being watching these videos. I believe, and let me pray with you. If you have any problem, those of you who are sick, I declare healing into your life. I declare divine healing into your life. In the name of Jesus, we rebuke the devourer on your behalf. This week shall be a week of success. This week shall be a week of victory. This week shall be a week of honor. May the name of our Lord Savior Jesus be blessed now and forever. Amen.